Welcome to Makeup Magic 88.
Hi all! Thanks so much for joining me again. I'm so happy you're here with me. Today I'm gonna do a quick review of some of Anna Sui's products for Try It Tuesday. Here I have the eye color palette. I think this is such a beautiful palette in terms of packaging. It has like these multicolored roses on it. It's just gorgeous. And then you open it up, you get 10 colors. And they're actually what I have on my eye. I really like this palette. This palette smells of roses, and as you can see, as I'm applying it on my eyes, it blends really well. It's highly pigmented, but I do think that there is some fallout, so you have to be really careful and tap up to your brush, or you just have to, you know, when you're putting on your eyeshadow, make sure you don't set your foundation yet, just sort of sweep it off or do your foundation after you do your eye makeup. So this is what it looks like up close. Really pretty. At the back it says eyeshadow palette 01. As far as I know, I think this is the only eyeshadow palette. There's also a lip palette that accompanies this one, which I didn't buy. The eyeshadows, you get 10 of them. Pretty colors, but I wish that there was more of a variation of tones. You only have like a lot of medium tone colors, one really dark one and one white one. And I'll just do some swatches for you. So I'm gonna swatch this copper color. That's gorgeous, highly pigmented and very smooth. There's that copper color there. Then we'll do the next color, which is more of like a taupe color. That one, there. Back of our hands. Little bit of fallout, but these blend quite well. I love this unusual pink that's been included. It's there. A bit more so you can see it. I don't have any primer on my hands, so this is just on very dry skin. This peach color is really nice, this one here. So it looks like that. There. And then we've got the white. The white has some very minor shimmers in it. The white is quite dry actually, but still quite nice in terms of pigmentation. Go this side now. And then get this nice bronzy color. I mean, this palette has all of the colors that I typically like, so I was quite drawn to it. A very nice purple there, and then a brown there. This unusual dark green, which has sparkles in it. See, put it over here. So the last one is this black color, and it has a lot of sparkles in it. It's really quite pretty. It looks like that. So I'll just put a swatch here. I don't have any primer on my hands at the moment. This is all on very dry skin, and you know that eyeshadows tend to be more intense when you have a primer under it. And these are the other colors there. Really nice, and you can see that black and green both have sparkles in it, which is really pretty. The next item is a blush in the sort of classic black Anna Sui packaging. She's actually gone away from this and turned to more sort of packaging that looks like this, which is super cool. It's really cute. Comes in a box like this. So it does match up with the eyeshadow palette, and it's called a rose cheek color, and the one I have here is 300, and I like it. It does have a fairly distinct rose smell to it, so if you don't mind the rose scent, I know some people don't mind it. This is actually quite a really pretty product, and I've also applied it on my cheeks, so you can see. And it's so pigmented, and I love how you can do like a swirl of all the colors, come up with a custom blend, or you can go from a lighter pink to a darker pink. So you can see that there are like different finishes in it. Like this one has sparkles in it, these ones are more matte and satin colors. You can really customize what kind of blush you want. you go a bit darker, you can go a bit lighter. And if you want to avoid like the sparkly bit in it, you might need to get like a brush that's quite pointed and just sort of pick up the color as you go and working around the sparkly rose there. This brush, these are the exciting things I wanted to show you. So she's come up with these new lipsticks, which are so pretty. I mean, look at the boxes. I think they're amazing. I picked up three colors, 370, 371 and 770 Lipstick M. And why I picked up these ones is because of the unusual nature of them, because they are two-toned. You can see how beautiful they are, and with that star tip of it, I mean, it's such, I almost don't want to use them at all. They're just so pretty. But I just want to try these on for you. So we'll start with 370. And you can see how gorgeous it is. It's like a dual tone. So it's supposed to give you like an ombre effect. So I'm going to just put this on my lips. I've already primed my lips with some lip balm. It's come out more like a frosty pink. I think it's quite pretty. It does have that rose scent, so in case you don't like rose scented products, you might not like this, but it's quite, it's definitely quite subtle. It's not that strong. And I feel like it's quite moisturizing. And if I look at it closely, I feel like there is some sparkle in it. So after one use, you can see sort of like the star pattern on it is starting to wear off, which is a bit of a pity. But you know, it was such a lovely product to start off with. Like all of her new range of lipsticks has that star and sort of twisted pattern to it, just like this. And I think that's so cool. I definitely want to try more of these. I think 370 is a really lovely color that you can wear in spring, summer, and you know, just for the holiday periods, because it's just so pretty. The next one I want to try is this one called 371. And you can look at it, and it's just, it's amazing how pretty they are. All NS3 products I made are in Japan, and this one is like more of a pink, hot pink with sort of brown violet stripes through it. And it's just crafted so well. I mean, this is fantastic in terms of the design. So let's just give it a try on now. I like the glossy finish. This is 371 in the sort of hot pink with the brown stripes in it. Really quite beautiful. And again, with one application, you sort of lost the star factor to it. It's quite moisturizing, I feel. It's quite light on the lips. Once it's on my lips, I can't smell that rose smell. But I think you definitely need to exfoliate your lips first, which I should have done. But otherwise, color and the formula is quite pretty. So the last one to try on is 770, and this one has gold in it and is more of a purpley color. It's very pretty. It's like marble the way they've done it, and we'll just see how it works. I think there might be a slight shimmer in it just by looking at it closely. With this one, 770, you get like a metallic effect. That's a close-up of it. I really like the finish. This is like almost like a very pinky purple goldish color, and it comes off a bit metallic. It's still very moisturizing. It's not sticky at all, and I really think this color is so beautiful.
So my final thoughts are, the palette is really nice. It's pretty, but the colours aren't that unique, and I would have liked to see a more variation of a tone to it. The formulation was okay, a bit powdery. As for the blush, I think this is such a pretty blush. And of course it would be rose scented because the whole theme is a rose cheek powder. So I think it's quite lovely and I think you can do quite a few things with it. As for the lipsticks, I think they are a standout. The packaging is beautiful. The formulation is delicious. I just really like how these colors combine. So these are from the Lipstick M series. They have a Lipstick B series where it's just one tone. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't, and please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye!